Welcome back. You cannot see them, and sometimes you can't smell them, but chances are environmental toxins are hiding in your cabinets, closets, and carpeting. According to the EPA, toxic chemicals in today's homes are 3 times more likely to cause cancer than any outdoor airborne pollutants. So what can you do to reduce toxic chemicals in your home? We're going to try to help you out on this. Environmental scientist Michael Wisner joins us, and welcome to the show.
Thank you. Nice being here.
Well, nice to have you here. This is such a scary topic. When you think about, you could be inhaling things in your home that are more harmful to you than outside.
Well, I think it's definitely one of concern. I mean, I don't want to scare people. There
right.
are safer alternatives for sure. But yeah, I mean, look at, you know, the US EPA said that every 2/3 of Americans today are at increased risk of cancer due to toxins in the home. And so we have to take a look at this. And the particularly vulnerable population are children. You know, we spray pesticides in the home.
Mm-hmm.
They're low to the ground.
Mm-hmm.
They had their hands and their fingers in every place that you could think of, put them in their mouth. And so studies have actually shown that were reported in USA Today just a month ago,
mm-hmm.
that children have high levels of certain pesticides and so forth in their blood that are of concern. And often this is more minority children in inner cities where there is more congestion, more pollution,
mm-hmm.
and more use of chemicals.
Okay, so it's not lead anymore. That's the big danger as
the good news. The good news on lead is it's actually gone down in children, but there's still about 700,000 children, 800,000 children in that range in this country that lead levels in their bodies are considered unhealthy. And most of that lead, we walk right into our homes off our shoes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I studied a program written by L. Ron Hubbard in the book Clear Body, Clear Mind, a detoxification program.
Mm-hmm.
And we had children come in to our clinic who had high lead levels. And we put them through this detoxification program, and the lead levels went down. Their IQs went back up.
Wow.
Their learning problems went away because of the lead. But going back to the source of it, 40% of the lead we expose to ourselves and our children come on the soles of our shoes into our home. We walk
wow.
it in off the street grid
uh-huh.
because lead goes up in the air and pollution comes down. If you take your shoes off the door and your family and just wear house slippers or house shoes
that
when you're inside,
40%
lead reduction for free. You know, I used to say to my son, that's why the Japanese students that go to your school have such high levels, you know, high grades in math, because they've been doing this for centuries.
They've taken off their shoes for a long time.
Right.
Well, let's talk about if you went through somebody's house,
sure.
what would be the first items you'd say, let's toss this out, let's toss that out?
First thing I'd say is get rid of the household pesticides. There are a lot of ways to kill bugs. I'm not saying to live with the cockroaches or some of the things I saw earlier on the show.
Yeah, we're living with them here.
I don't think I'd want to live. No, thanks. No, but there are safe ways, like there's a chrysanthemum plant that a pyrethrin comes from, which is a natural pesticide that will not harm your children. I mean, I wouldn't spray it on my Rice Krispies, but but seriously, it will deter bugs and so forth. There's boric acid, again, placed correctly, safely in the home, is going to deter bugs. There's many safe things you can do to get rid of bugs without spraying household pesticides. I mean, studies at USC have shown that just household pesticide use once or twice a week in homes compared to homes that don't use them,
mm-hmm.
the incidence of childhood leukemia is 700 times higher.
Wow.
So it doesn't take a lot of chemical to show a statistically significant increase in diseases to children.
Now, what's in the carpeting at home that we should be concerned about?
It's one of the scariest things, you know, because years ago we didn't have wall-to-wall carpeting. It came with synthetic fibers. Basically, it's a harbinger of disease. I mean, because bacteria, viruses, dust mites can all, they all live there. So one of the things you can do is clean your carpets regularly. Don't use chemical spot removers because that's been associated with other diseases. Kelly Preston and I were on the Montel show not too long ago, and one of her children had been poisoned by the chemical used for spot removing in carpets.
Really?
There's safe ways to reduce spots and so forth.
How should you do it?
Well, citric cleaners that are citric based, like orange based, will clean spots out of material, out of carpeting and so forth. Much safer. I think that you can use whenever you can, when you have a choice, use hardwood floors, tiles, as opposed to wall-to-wall carpeting, because it gives you much easier way to clean the home.
Now, how do you clean your children's bedrooms, since they are so sensitive and they have these immune systems that are not as strong? What should you do in their
first bedroom? Thing is, don't use pesticides and things in there. Second thing, you can clean almost everything in the home without using abrasive chemicals, ones with petroleum distillates and things like that you see right in the labels
so
in the store.
So make sure it doesn't have the petroleum base.
Right.
And you also said not to spray that much?
Well, not, I wouldn't spray chemicals, but if you use baking soda, vinegar, water, lemon juice, you can clean almost everything in the house without using a chemical. And by the way, it's a lot cheaper.
That's true.
It's a lot cheaper. Now, if you have chemical exposure in the home or if you're concerned, you can always have that tested. And then detoxification is something that is is available. You know, I mean, I was one of the scientific researchers on the book that I mentioned by Mr. Hubbard called Clear Body, Clear Mind, and we found in 3,000 clinical cases, people like you and I who hadn't had poisoning, okay, we saw increases in IQ, reaction time, okay, both in children, learning rates, and in adults, greater energy, greater, you know, they thought clearer, they were healthier. And so there is an avenue if there has been a chemical exposure.
All right, thank you so much. This helps a lot because a lot of people get scared when they hear about this type of thing. So we appreciate all the alternatives you discussed.
You bet.
And for more information about household toxins and detoxification, check out the book Clear Body and Clear Mind that he alluded to by L. Ron Hubbard. And you can also log on to clearbodyclearmind.com. And you can also see Michael Wisner tonight. He is speaking at 5 o'clock at the Borders Bookstore on the corner of Coit and Arapahoe in Dallas. Scott?
There's a break.
All right. Thank you very much, Bill. It happened in Vietnam and it happened in Desert Storm. The question is, will the same thing happen now to our troops coming home from Iraq? Exposure to mysterious and debilitating symptoms from chemicals on the battlefield. Retired Lieutenant Colonel Bob Wolfert asserts American soldiers may soon be fighting for their health. The Colonel Wolfert joins us today to talk about that threat. First of all, Colonel, thanks for being with us.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Pleasure to meet you. Talk about your symptoms. You fought in the Gulf War and came home, then all of a sudden something happened.
That's correct. Fortunately, the something happened. I'm one of about, I think it's somewhere in the neighborhood of 80,000 to 100,000 who are in the Persian Gulf Registry for Gulf War illness. I'm the only one I know of who's symptom-free today as a result of having gone through a program at Health Med California based on a book by L. Ron Hubbard called Clear Body, Clear Mind.
What did you notice was wrong with you that was different from when you went over there?
I experienced all the things that you've heard about, fatigue, the joint aches. I had them traveling from my elbow to my shoulder. Yeah, my knee, my hip. Frequent headaches, rashes that came and went, the short-term memory loss. My wife would tell you I was grouchy, too.
Okay, yeah, I'd read that. But at first, nobody believed you or all the other veterans who said something was wrong with them.
That was challenging because my first experience with the VA was that you know, maybe there's something psychologically wrong, and there were a number of other veterans who had that same experience.
That wouldn't be so unusual for a combat veteran, would it?
Those type things do happen, but there were physical manifestations of what was going on. I mean, I'm not sure how psychologically you make a rash come or go.
Sure.
It's hard to demonstrate a joint ache. The fatigue was certainly there, and those other things. But I also had a sty on my right eyelid that came and went every 2 weeks like clockwork. None of these things happened before the Gulf War.
No kidding. Well, you know, of course, we have Fort Campbell right here in our own backyard, and then thousands and thousands of young men and women are over there. And you're not so much pushing L. Ron Hubbard's book, but worried about these people who are over there and who might come back in the same situation as you.
Well, L. Ron Hubbard's book outlined the program that I went through at Health Med in California, and the sweating in a sauna, which is part of the program, exercise, vitamin and nutrient replacement. Cleared junk out of my system, and I again felt wonderful and became symptom free. So my hope is that the folks coming back from this latest conflict won't experience those things. But if they do, not to ignore the symptoms, pay attention to them, go to the VA, let them know that they have them. Be aware that there's a book like Clear Body, Clear Mind. There's a website they can go to. It's clearbodyclearmind.com. Mm-hmm. Help is available. People can be treated.
Because I suspect as a soldier, your threshold for pain is probably pretty high. And I would also suspect that you have a joint ache here and there coming back being in the desert. You might just put it on the back burner for a while.
That's true. And again, I would emphasize that if there's something that you didn't have before you went that you have afterward.
Is that the key for you if you didn't?
If it wasn't there beforehand and you got it afterward, I pay attention to it.
Now, this clinic that you went out to California, how long of a regime was that?
Actually, the regime that's there is used to release toxins. They've had treated a number of folks there. In fact, those who've gone through the program identified in the book, there's over 250,000 people who are either with toxin exposures or drug addiction who are no longer using. Mm-hmm. That program can get that junk cleared out of the system.
Well, the situation now in the war, we didn't see the giant fires that we saw in the Gulf War as you had to deal with.
That's correct.
Do you think the incidence will be as high as when these soldiers return of Gulf War syndrome?
Unfortunately, the cause of Gulf War syndrome has never really been nailed down. I saw a recent study where it was attributed to pesticides. Mm-hmm. But the exposures that were detailed in that study were not my experience with pesticides. And I think it was probably a combination of things. The burning oil fields, the chemicals, the pesticides, any number of things, which this time didn't necessarily happen. For example, there were very few burning oil fields
right,
this time.
Exactly.
I spent 2 weeks in smoke-filled atmosphere.
That must have been something.
So, again, hopefully these troops coming back won't have it. There are certainly, we've fought the same enemy in the same region of the world, so who knows what's going to happen.
Just be aware.
Be aware.
All right, Colonel, thanks very much for being with us. By the way, the book is called Clear Body, Clear Mind by L. Ron Hubbard. It's available at all bookstores if you would like to get a copy of it.